Hello and welcome to High Voltages. In this video, we are going to update the project that we started last time. In the last video, we learned how we can use MQTT in Python. We subscribed and published the data to ESP8266 using MQTT protocol and made a nice and clean dashboard. In this video, we will be upgrading the same project and we will write the code for logging data in Excel file. And we will plot the real-time data in the same graphical user interface. If you don't know what is MQTT protocol and want to use MQTT in another platform, consider watching my previous videos in which I have covered how to use MQTT in ESP8266, Python, MATLAB, and we have discussed how to make MQTT broker using Raspberry Pi and discussed the MQTT clouds. So before starting, I would like you to subscribe so I can keep making such videos. Let's start with the first part, that is the logging of data in an Excel file. There are a number of libraries that we can use to handle CSV or Excel files in Python, but I will be using the CSV library as it is easy to use. So let's start by importing the library. You can install the library by using the pip3 install csv command. Now, let's create a function that can create our Excel file and add headers to our CSV or Excel file. So, the idea is that if a file is not already created, create a file and add headers. And how we will do that? Well, I have written a try and accept statement. In try, Python will try to read a file. If file has been already read, it will return. Otherwise, it will generate an exception that file is not present, and that means we will have to create a file and add headers. Now, if we run our code, you will see that file has been created and you can see the headers only. The next thing is to create a function that can log data in our Excel file, and that will be called whenever we get a message on our subscribe topics. So I will write a function that takes two parameters for getting the values of temperature and humidity. And in the function, we will first read the Excel file and it will read the number of lines and add 1 to it. We will read time and date using the DateTime library. And also we will need to import the DateTime library. And then we will open a file with append permission and write the data as comma separated values, temperature, humidity, and current time and date. The difference between append and write is that append helps us to update the Excel file, whereas write will override the file. Now we have to go to onMessage function, which is called whenever we receive a message on our subscribe topics. And in the end, we will call the writeData function and pass the temperature and humidity values. And now if we will run the program, we will see an Excel file with the values of temperature, humidity, and date time. So the first part, pretty simple, is completed. Now let's move on to the real-time plotting. For plotting the data, we will use the matplotlib. So let's do pip3 install matplotlib. And then import the required libraries. First we will import the matplotlib itself and then we will define the backend that we want to use. We will write tkagg as we are implementing the matplotlib in tkinter window. And we will import other required libraries that will help us to import the frames, figures that we can use in our tkinter window and navigation toolbar, which I will show you later in the project. Now let's create another function that will read data from Excel file and plot it. So I will create a function getData and plot it. So first thing, I will read Excel file and create three empty lists to read temperature, humidity, and lines. You can also read date and plot temperature versus date, but for simplicity, we are plotting lines versus temperature and humidity. And then we will create a figure, tell figure size, DPI, and then we will add a plot to figure. 211 means there are two rows, one column, and this is figure number 1. And we will write a title temperature, as this first subplot is for temperature. And then using the plot command, we will pass the temperature and lines data that we just read from the Excel file. We are passing the last 12 values so that graph looks clean. And then we will add the other plot and use 212. It means it is second subplot graph and title is humidity. And we will pass the data of humidity. Then we will adjust the spacing between those two subplots. After doing that, we will create a canvas and pass the figure and main Tkinter window, and then using the draw function, our canvas will be drawn, and we will place it in the right side of the window using the x and y axis values. Similarly, we will add the toolbar that will help us to zoom in, zoom out, scroll our graph, and we will place it under the figure. In the end, we will write win.after 10,000 get data and plot it function. That means it will be updated after every 10 seconds. And we will call this function in the beginning of program as well. So the program is ready. Let's test it and see the values. That's it. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe for more such videos. Questions are welcome. I will try to answer each of them.